Despite the scandals, Woody Allen will make movies forever. Why? Well, first off, because his movies are extremely cheap to make, so it really costs nobody anything. And also, recently, they've actually started to make a decent amount of money, or at least some of the times they do. He used to be infamous for his films never turning a profit, but he's always been pretty good at winning people awards. So, say what you will about a number of high-caliber or up-and-coming actors, mainstream actors, who are willing to work with Woody Allen, and it doesn't seem to have a stigma that goes along with it, you know, despite, again, the scandals, for the chance to either win an award or get some credibility as an actor. And of course, that's what Justin Timberlake's going to be doing right here. Scarlett Johansson worked her way through Woody Allen. Emma Stone did. You know, he has his favorites, but I think it's when he finds somebody new that his material shines the most. You know, I think the last film that he did that was like a new kind of Woody Allen movie that made a lot of money and it won awards was, of course, Blue Jasmine, which kind of gave Cate Blanchett a second or third lease on her career. She's doing quite well now. And now Kate Winslet is here. And of course, people are talking about Woody Allen's next project already. Very interesting cast being assembled there. Diego Luna, Timothy Chalamet. But also people are talking about Kate Winslet, who stars here, because of course she just signed on for the Avatar movies. But after you do the Divergent films, is your joining a film still quite as prestigious? We shall see. We'll see what happens with her in Avatar, and let's see how she's doing with Woody. All right.
Coney Island, 1950s. The beach, the boardwalk. I work here on Bay 7.
You look great already, Justin.
Enter Carolina.
Excuse me, do you know if Jenny's here?
I'm Jenny.
I'm Humpty's daughter. You're his wife?
Is he gonna be surprised?
I'm marked. They're gonna kill me.
That's what you get when you marry a gangster.
I gotta have a drink.
No, Humpty, you've been good.
Damn it!
Miss, you can't be out here right now. We're expecting lightning storms.
When you're married to a man who got rich putting people's feet in cement, you probably never had to do a dish.
Your wife don't like to go fishing anymore, Humpty.
She made like she liked it. To get me on the hook, I was the fish.
You know she's a marked woman.
Should she move on?
I know where all the bodies are buried.
Did he kiss you?
Why are you getting so heated?
I'm gonna find
him. My head is pounding.
Everything's coming apart.
You look a little crazy to me.
When it comes to love, we often turn out to be our own worst enemy.
I know what it is you did.
Oh, don't you think you're being a little melodramatic?
I think you are. And it's great. This looks like one of the important ones. They're all pleasant. I didn't like Cafe Society, actually. I thought that was not a fabulous movie. But for the most part, Woody Allen's movies are always, you know, enjoyable. But this one looks really interesting. I think Kate Winslet, she does seem a lot like Cate Blanchett and Blue Jasmine. Very similar type roles. I love her hair. That red, messy hair looks fantastic. Also, I'm getting very strong. And that was also the case with Blue Jasmine. Very strong Streetcar Named Desire vibes, interestingly enough. And I love the color. I love the way they made Coney Island look. It seems like a very whimsical background for the story that they're telling. That must be obviously intentional. But it reminds me of one of my favorite movies, so I'm inclined to like it. But if you've ever seen Douglas Sirk's version of Imitation of Life, it has some opening scenes or in the beginning of the movie at Coney Island. And of course, it has that beautiful Technicolor look. Douglas Sirk did a fabulous job, and you know, Woody Allen has done a very nice job capturing it in the same way. And I'm sure that's also intentional. So you've got a mix of like Douglas Sirk melodrama, and I can certainly see shades of that in the narrative as well. And then it has a theatrical feel to it, like Streetcar Named Desire. I'm very curious to see what's going on here. It's a good teaser trailer. I would have liked to have seen a little bit more Justin Timberlake. Maybe he has a small role. I think that movie trailers should be very careful about, you know, selling you on seeing a movie for an actor and then doing the old bait and switch where they're like, surprise, they're actually not very much in the movie. And as I've said, that's the case with the current Blade Runner 2049 movie, where there is not a lot of Harrison Ford or even Jared Leto in the actual film. But I think that I think that Justin Timberlake looks like he's doing a nice job. But it looks very much like the Kate Winslet show. And how about Belushi in there, right? That's pretty crazy. Although he's a pretty good, I think, realistic Stanley Kowalski. Although, of course, you can't knock Brando, one of the greatest performances of all time. So what did you think? Does it look good to you? What do you think of Woody Allen movies? Do you like all Woody Allen movies? Are you surprised that he's able to continue to work? Do you agree with me why that is? Actually, I have to say, I saw him, I was traveling this summer. I was in Cannes for a few days, and I actually ran across Woody Allen, and he looked appropriately odd. Let's just leave it at that. We'll chalk it up to his artistic sensibilities, I guess. All right, so let's just say I think that Woody Allen has not gotten any better. All right, so write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.